Hi friends, welcome to Tackle Knowledge channel. So today we are going to see about the plasma membrane structure. Okay. Phospholipids. The membrane is partially made up of molecules called phospholipids. So the plasma membrane is made up of a phospholipids. Okay. So they are made up of a partially molecules. Okay. Which spontaneously arrange themselves into a double layer with the hydrophilic water loving head on the outer side and the hydrophobic water hating tail on the inside. So if we see the phospholipid bilayer of the plasma membrane, the outer side is the hydrophilic. Okay, hydrophilic means it's a water loving. Okay, hydrophilic heads are present. So if we see the middle part of this is the hydrophobic tails. Okay, hydrophobic tails which are present inside the plasma membrane. Okay, these hydrophilic heads are outer side of the plasma membrane and the hydrophobic tails are inside the plasma membrane. Okay, these interactions with water are what allow plasma membrane to form. So these interactions are with water. Okay, so the plasma membrane which is in a bilayer form is going to interact with water only. Okay, where to allow the water in the plasma membrane. So wherever the hydrophobic tail is present, the water cannot enter in that particular region. Okay. Next, proteins. Proteins are wedged between the lipids that make up the membrane. So if we see the proteins like peripheral protein, integral proteins, right? So these proteins are wedged inside the plasma membrane. Okay. Between the lipids. So this hydrophilic head and hydrophobic tails is a phospholipid, right? So this is the phospholipid, that's why we are saying that the proteins are wedged between the lipids. Okay, this is the phospholipid. Okay, and these transmembrane proteins allows molecules that could enter these cells otherwise to pass through by forming cells. So if we see the proteins which are embedded in this plasma membrane, they are going to allow molecules which one to enter the plasma membrane or which one it should not enter. Okay, so we can say this proteins as a transmembrane proteins. Okay, they can be calling it as a transmembrane proteins. We can call this as a transmembrane proteins. Forming channels, pores or gates. So this particular molecule has to enter through channels, right? So this is one channel and it is also having a pores where the molecule will be entering, and it is also having a gates, right? So this is the gate. Okay, in this way the cell controls the flow of these molecules as they enter and exit. So in this way the plasma membrane is controlling the molecules whether they have to enter the cell or exit the cell. Okay, proteins in the cell membrane play a role in many other functions such as cell signaling, cell recognition and enzyme activity. So proteins in the cell membrane plays an important role in many other functions like cell signaling, right? So one is the cell signaling, another one is the cell recognition and enzyme activity. Okay, next we will be seeing about the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates are also found in the plasma membrane. So if we see here, there are carbohydrates. So these carbohydrates are present in the plasma membrane. Okay, specifically most carbohydrates in the membrane are part of glycoproteins. So specifically more carbohydrates are glycoproteins, okay, which are formed when a carbohydrate attaches to a protein. So glycoprotein is going to form it is going to attach with the carbohydrate. Okay, means carbohydrate attaches to a protein. So if we see here, so this is the glycoprotein and this Y-like structure is a carbohydrate. Okay, so this carbohydrate is attached with the protein. Okay, Likewise, these glycoproteins, which are formed when a carbohydrate attaches to a protein. Glycoproteins plays a role in the interactions between cells, including cell adhesion, the proteins, the process by which cells attaches to each other. So if you see the glycoproteins, they play an important role in interactions like cell adhesions. Okay, cell adhesion means it's a process where the cell attaches with each other. Okay, cell attaches with each other. Okay, fluid mosaic model. Technically, the cell membrane is a liquid, so technically we can call it as a cell membrane is in a liquid form. Okay, at room temperature it has about the same consistency as vegetable oil. So at room temperature the plasma membrane is about a same consistency as a vegetable oil. Okay, lipids, proteins and carbohydrates in the plasma membrane can diffuse freely throughout the cell membrane. So lipids, proteins and carbohydrates which are present on the plasma membrane, they can diffuse freely. Okay, they can diffuse freely through the cell membrane. So they can diffuse here to here and here to here. Okay, they can diffuse in this particular plasma membrane itself. Okay, they are essentially floating across its surface. So they are essentially floating across the surface only, right? So next, this is known as fluid mosaic model. So fluid mosaic model means it's a plasma membrane has been named it as a fluid mosaic model. So which was coined by S.J. Singer Nicholson. Okay, they were the two scientists who named this plasma membrane as a fluid mosaic model. Okay, S.J. Singer and G.L. Nicholson in 1972, scientists have coined the plasma membrane as a fluid mosaic model. Okay, related biology terms. Cell wall, a structure that surrounds the plasma membrane of plant and fungus cells and provide additional support to those cells. So if we see the cell wall, a structure is surrounded by a plasma membrane in plant cells and a fungus cells. Okay, so it is giving an additional support to those cells. Okay, phospholipids, a molecule that forms the characteristic double layers of the plasma membrane. So if you see the phospholipid, it is a molecule forming a characteristics of a double layer of a plasma membrane. Okay, so the plasma membrane is in a double layer form. Semi-permeable, allowing only certain molecules to pass through due to chemical properties of the membrane. So if we see the plasma membrane, it is a semi-permeable membrane, right? So it is allowing only certain molecules to pass through the membrane. Okay, fluid mosaic model, a model that describes the composition of the plasma membrane and how phospholipids, proteins and carbohydrates freely move within it. So fluid mosaic model means it is a model where the composition of the plasma membrane and how the phospholipids, proteins, carbohydrates are freely moving within the plasma membrane itself. Okay, so this is about the plasma membrane structure. Okay friends, thank you. Thanks for watching. If you like my video, please kindly like, share and subscribe it with your friends. Okay, thank you. Thank you so much. Bye bye.